But they snapped. Amen. They would also wet their cotton down with whatever they could. All right. What a way. Amen. And you're talking about $2 a hundred. Amen. You know, the best pickers in the world could only pick about 300 or 400 pounds a day. So they were getting paid $6 a day. Amen. The average picker was getting, I'm talking about, this was a day was a can to Kent day. All right. Amen. They were not short days. They were long days. They were not 8-hour days. Come on now. Praise the Lord. A lot of times they were 16 hours. Amen. They had to get paid under the light of the headlight of the truck. All right. It was dark. All right. So that's what you had. A lot of times when you had it outsourced to people who wasn't us. Now, we always wanted clean cotton because we know we made the money off of the clean cotton. But because it was other people who were doing it, they would oftentimes, you know, do whatever they could to make the most money. Same way it is, and I'm pretty sure it is with companies today, they do whatever they can. They'll even take shortcuts to make sure that they fulfill the, you know, the terms of their contract so that they can get paid. That's what outsourcing is. Ah, so where does it come? It's almost like a lot of times when it comes to the gospel again, that people treat it as though the Lord has outsourced it, and that men have, you know, they can do whatever they want now with his church. So much so that today we got, we're not going to beat up on anybody today, but this is just about the exaltation of the truth of God. Amen. Today we got people in different organizations and different church groupings, amen, that I'm talking about have let abomination, amen, come into their assemblies. Amen. So much so that the Episcopalians a few years ago, amen, they ordained a active homosexual bishop with his partner sitting in the congregation, a man. Something is wrong with that picture.
That's right.
That's what you call outsourcing. Amen. People who think that they can do whatever they want with the word of God, and that God is, and all that God, the only relationship that God has with his church is something like some fiduciary or legal, you know, relationship. See, God is taking care of business in heaven. We've got to take care of business on earth.
That's right.
Yeah. Amen. That's what I'm telling you all. That's the, now hold on. Something is wrong with that statement. Because that's the kind of idea that a lot of people think. God is busy in heaven. We've got to be busy on earth. Amen. See, that's... No, God is busy on earth. Amen. God is not just busy in heaven. Amen. And this is where a lot of times the conceptual idea, amen, is that God is busy in heaven, so men got to take care of the responsibility on earth. Amen. Nothing can be further from the truth. Amen. When Jesus said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you, I'll be with you to the even to the end of the age, he was not lying. Amen. So he did not outsource the preaching of the gospel to Peter, to Paul, to James, to John, to Luke. No, he did not. What he did was he birthed them into the kingdom of God. Yes, yes. So that, amen, it was no longer them who were preaching, but it was Christ in them. He was doing the work. Amen. God has not outsourced it to men, but a lot of men have taken it upon themselves to steal the gospel of Jesus Christ. There's a saying that says some was sent and others just went. Yeah. Yeah. Amen. Hallelujah. You got some that just took it upon themselves because the gospel is a very profitable undertaking. You see, a whole lot of times, you know, religion, if you can get people to thinking that God has something over them, and because you got the connection with God and God got something on them, you can get them to thinking that they owe you everything in their life. See, that's not the gospel of Jesus Christ. Jesus said, "You shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free." Amen. Hallelujah. Yes. Jesus said, amen, go boldly to the throne of grace. Yes. For you shall obtain mercy and find grace to help in the time of need. Yes. Yes. He didn't tell you to go to some man and let them go for you. He said you need to go. Come on, somebody. Yes. You need to go for yourself.
Yes.
My God. You have the authority. He said, I've made you kings and priests unto God, and you have the authority to go into the holiest of holiest and say, God, you are able to, amen, meet my need. God, your ears is not heavy that you cannot hear my prayer. Your arm is not short that you cannot save. God, Lord, I'm believing. Hallelujah. You got to know within yourself that God listens to your voice.
Hallelujah.
Amen. He does not listen to my voice over your voice. Come on, somebody. You got to know this. But a lot of times people, men, want you to believe that because they wear a certain title or wear a certain, you know, piece of vesture, amen, or wear a certain, you know, y'all hear what I'm saying?
Yeah,
that they've got it up on you. Church, God has no little eyes and big you.
Come on now.
Or little you's and big eyes.
Right.
No, the Bible said God has tempered everybody in the kingdom. He's got one body and many members, and all members have the same glory.
Yes.
My God. All members, everybody is important in the kingdom of God. And you need to raise up and stir up and know this, that God realizes that you are important in the body. My God, don't ever think of yourself less than you are. Because the Bible says, as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he.
That's right.
My God, hallelujah. So so church, is very important for us to have a wake-up call in this day, because in this day you have some of the most educated fools that ever existed. I'm talking about they know and don't know nothing. Amen. These were the same ones that the Lord addressed in the book of Revelation, chapter number 3. He says that you say that you are rich, increased with goods, and have need of nothing, and you don't know that you are poor, wretched, blind, miserable, naked, and dumb. You don't know how bad it is. You think that you are rich and increasing, and you don't have no needs. My God, and you're the ones that have all of the needs. Church of God, it's a wake-up call. God did not outsource anything. Amen. He did not take a hand. He does not take a hands-off approach when it comes to his word. He does not farm it out, amen, to somebody who do not have an intimate relationship with his word.
Come on.
Amen. He does not relegate it and leave it to anybody, amen, who do not really have a true cause and care for his word. God wants intimacy with his word. Amen?
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
My God. Hallelujah. 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 Now, church, amen, we don't have to. Now, I just want to start with the last verse. When you go into the Bible, you don't have to go back. I'm telling you, this is not a present day thing. In the Bible, there were folks who tried to steal the word of God for profit. In Acts chapter number 8, Simon the sorcerer said that, told Peter, let me buy this power. Amen. He said, I got enough money. All I want to do is buy what you got so that I can, you know, so I can gain folks. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That happened in Acts chapter number 8. Amen. In Acts chapter number 19, the seven sons of Sceva, they knew the power that was in the name
Come
of Jesus.
Now.
They had seen Paul bind, casting devils out. They had witnessed, amen, the apostles doing the work of God. And these seven sons of this prophet Sceva, they went out and they came to this demon and said, in the name of Jesus, we command you to come out of this man. That devil that was in that man said to them, those seven sons, they said, Jesus we know, and Paul we know, but we don't know who you are. And that devil beat them up like they stole something. Amen. That devil whooped them up so that the scripture says that they, when they left that devil, their clothes, they was running and their clothes was all torn up off of them. Amen. Amen, church, it really happened. Amen. In Acts chapter number 19. Amen. Even a more pervasive situation happened a little bit later on. And I want y'all to watch how progress it got. See, Simon just wanted to buy it, amen, but he was rebuked of Peter. The seven sons of Sceva, they done went a little bit deeper. They said that we're not going to try to buy nothing. We're just going to take the authority and exercise his name. My God, and the devils beat him up. Watch how now, amen, it has even got more pervasive when you get deeper into the scripture. Because when you get to 3 John, Diotrephes, amen, not only did he not want to buy it, not only did he not just wanted to use the name of Jesus, but Diotrephes had found himself in the preeminent position in the